Welcome to this module of the Windows 8 Line of Business App Deployment course. In this particular module, we're going to be having a look at sideloading an application onto a Windows 8 device using Windows Intune as our mechanism for deploying our application. The objectives of this particular module are to get you ready to be able to use Windows Intune to be able to sideload an application onto a target device. So the first thing we're going to do is create an application based on an APEX package that we already have. We're then going to deploy that APEX package out to some users of our Windows Intune tenant. And then finally, we're going to have a look at the experience on the device of actually obtaining the application from Windows Intune. There are a few assumptions that we have in place for this module. The first one, of course, is that you do have the APEX files for your application. If you don't, then hopefully the files for the app are available through the Windows Store, and you're actually looking to deploy a Windows Store application using the deep linking process. The second is that your Windows 8 device is enabled for sideloading. If you have a Windows 8 Pro device, that means that you've installed sideloading product keys onto that device. It is possible to do that by scripting and using Windows Intune. You'll find some details of what you might need to script in the first one of the modules of this course. Finally, we are assuming that the client devices don't have the Configuration Manager client installed, unlike it says on screen there, because the two clients are not entirely compatible with each other. So, without further ado, let's get on to actually trying to deploy an APEX package. We're going to go and enter our Windows Intune management portal, and we're going to add the APEX package that we want to deploy through Windows Intune. So here I am inside of my Windows Intune tenant. I've signed in using the administrator credentials for my tenant. You can see that I've got a few alerts going off here, not stuff that I'm particularly interested in at this point in time. I'm just going to go down to my software view just here, and we'll have a look at the software that's been uploaded into Windows Intune or that's been detected across our Windows Intune estate. In this case, nothing has actually been detected apart from a whole load of applications that have been installed onto one or two devices that have been added into the environment. And within managed software, we just have one particular application that we've deployed, and that is in fact OneNote for Windows 8, which is taken from the Windows Store. It is actually a deep linked application, which we're going to have a look at a little later on. First though, we'll go back to our overview. And on the right-hand side here, we have a step to add software. So we're going to go ahead and click that. That's going to then cause a security scan to run on a piece of software which just has started to download in order to be able to access the various bits of information we need together in order to install the application into Windows Intune. So that's running as a click once application. We downloaded the latest version of the binaries from the internet right now. And we get an application security warning. We'll say run. We're expecting that to happen. That's perfectly okay. It's going to pull down all of the binaries for the Intune software publisher. And once that's done, we'll have a file security warning. We'll say run. Obviously, it's downloaded a file from the internet, hence the reason for that. And it's going to ask us to sign into our Windows Intune tenant. It's going to need exactly the same sign-in details that we provided for the console that you can see running in the background still. Once that's given us our logon details, we'll just enter the right details there. And once we've signed in, the add software wizard will know whereabouts to upload our particular APEX file to inside of the Windows Intune cloud, i.e. which tenant is our tenant. Now we can go through a process of learning how to publish software, but we already know that, so I click Next. Then I can specify the type of installation that I want. I'm going to say this is a software installer, and then I can say what type of software installer I want. In this case, I'm going to go for a Windows App X package, but notice that I could also be uploading for iOS, for Android, or for a Windows Phone package. I'll then browse to the location of my files. These are actually stored currently on my Configuration Manager server, so locations may well vary depending on where I've actually stored your software. I'll select the Technet UK APEX file, say open, and then we'll say next. Then we need to provide some information about this app so that Windows Intune can give the end user some useful information about the app they're about to install. And if we want to provide any extra URL details about where to find more information about the software, we can pop those in there too. Finally, we can say what category the app should appear under in underneath the company portal. So in this case, I'm going to say that this particular app should be under business. And I can provide an icon to have more information if I wanted to. I'm going to say next on this though, and upload. That's going to then take the APEX file, upload it into Windows Azure. The Windows Intune services use Windows Azure storage in order to be able to provide you with a storage space in order to be able to keep your applications. And if I just move this window across the right, you'll see that by default, 60 gigabytes of storage space for your apps inside of Windows Intune. It's going to take a few seconds to run through and complete the upload. And once it's done that, we will click close. I'll close down the uploading software, and if we go back into Manage Software inside of our Windows Intune tenant, then we'll be able to see the Technet UK application that we just uploaded. So now that we've got our application inside of our Windows Intune tenant, the next thing that we need to do is go and deploy it out to our end users. So we're going to go back across into our Windows Intune tenant and have a look at what we need in place in order to be able to deploy the app out to our end users. So here we are back inside of our console, and we have our Technet UK application highlighted. I'm going to go across to the Manage Deployment button, and that's going to have a look at the groups that we have set up within our Windows Intune tenant here. You see that I have an ungrouped users area and also a group for all of our users, our fake URL business apps. So in this case, I'm actually going to just target this to our ungrouped users. I'll say add. That moves them across into the grouped action. Next, and then we have to decide what deployment action we want to use. And in this case, we only actually have a couple available. Do not install, which we obviously don't want to be using, and available install. So we're going to select available. Note that one of the things that we can't do here is say that the install is required. Even though this is a sideloaded application, we can't set a sideloaded application to be required within Windows Intune, unlike we can within Configuration Manager. I'm going to say finish at this point. And that's going to then publish the application into our software catalog. I'm now just going to go back across to the administration work pane. And we're going to have a quick look for the company portal details. So we just go down to company portal, scroll down a little here. This is the place where we can get the details about the company portal that we're going to deploy to our end users. And you'll notice that at the bottom, we have a URL for portal.managemicrosoft.com, which is where one single place where our end users can go in order to be able to connect to our Windows Intune environment. And we're going to make use of that in just a moment. Go back to groups and select our ungrouped users. Finally, from here, we're going to select users, and that's going to show users who are available inside of our tenant. And you can see that I've set one up here for my Alice user, so that we have a user account who is able to enroll her own devices into the Windows Intune tenant. What I'm going to do now is move across to my client device. So I'll just minimize the, in fact, actually, I can just switch straight across to my Win85 device. And on this particular device, I've already opened up the portal.managemicrosoft.com website. And here I can log this in as my Alice account. And it's probably worth noting that at this point, I could be typing in my normal company domain name here. The reason I'm using the fake URL mgmt.onmicrosoft.com account is because that's just an easy way for me to have set up a demo account. And I'll just say sign in. And this then takes Alice into the fake URL limited company portal page. Here she can go and browse for particular apps that have been made available to her. And the very first thing that it does is actually pops up a notice to say that she needs to go and download the company store app in order to be able to install applications onto this device. I'm actually going to skip this for now because there's another step that she needs to do as well. She's just going to go across to the All Devices section, and we'll see all of the devices that Alice has actually enrolled into her Windows Intune account. Right now, our current computer is not enrolled into Windows Intune. She has her home PC and her Surface RT enrolled. What we're going to do is enroll this particular device. So I'll select Enroll, and that is going to allow me to download the client software onto my device so that I can set this machine up to attach to Windows Intune. So I hit the download software, and I'll say run. And that's just going to go ahead and run the installation for Windows Intune once it's downloaded. If I have a Windows RT device that I'm connecting, I don't need to do this because we've built much of this connectivity directly into Windows RT. So now that client's running, it's going to ask me to enter my details so that it can download the correct client certificate for this particular tenant. So I'm going to sign in again as Alice. And we'll just run through this wizard. It's going to ask us to elevate because we aren't an administrator on this machine. So you can see that in order to enroll a device within within Windows Intune on Windows 8, you do actually require administrative access to the machine. And now that our Windows 8 client is installed, we're able to connect into our Windows Intune environment. And in fact, if we go down to the bottom here, we'll start to see the PC is protected, and we'll start to see that actually Windows Intune will slowly start to take this machine over. I'll just switch back across to my Internet Explorer window here. Go back to a previous page. In fact, we might need to log back into the portal again. And now within all my devices, you can see that the Win805 device that we're connecting to from at the moment is actually added in there. And I could rename that if I wanted to do something a little bit more useful, if that would help me to remember my device. I'll just go back to the fake URL limited homepage and go into apps again. And it's now telling me that I need to go to the store and get hold of the company portal app just as it did before. This time, I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to open up the Windows Store. And it's going to take me straight to the company portal app. So I'm going to go and select where I want to install that application. And then we'll get a little notification to tell us that the store app is downloading the company portal app for us. There we go. And if we move back to the start screen, we'll see the Telnet UK app, the Skype app, and we can see the tile for the company portal, which has now been fully installed. So we'll go and launch that company portal. And it's going to need us to sign in to the particular Windows Intune tenant again. So the user is again going to provide exactly the same details. Normally, as I say, you would have created the account here to match the user's normal email address, and you may well have federated your identity to Windows Intune as well so that it does completely match up with the user's normal logon name. I'm going to say to keep me signed in, and I'll sign in again just there. What this will do is connect the company portal application up to our Windows Intune 7, and the user might be asked in the future to log in a few more times just to make sure that your information is completely secure. Here you can see the Taxonomy UK app that we just published, but we can also go down and browse by category. And from here we can see the business category that we added the Taxonomy UK app into. And within there we'll see the Taxonomy UK app. And highlight the application and select to reinstall that app. You notice that it's already detected that the app has been installed onto our device via some other route, because details like the publisher name and the version number are already available on this particular machine. So we'll say reinstall. But in the case of a new user coming along with a new application, they would select to install that completely fresh application. Reinstall the application that we already have installed on our machine. You can already see that the Windows Intune Center component for Windows Intune has already started to install itself in the background as well. Thanks very much for taking part in this module. In the next module, we're going to have a look at deep linking an application using Windows Intune in order to be able to deploy an application directly from the Windows Store to our client device.